Here comes the dimension for the various physical parameters or physical variables. Here, in the last session, we discussed about the derivation of the dimension by using formula and also by using SI units. The only two methods to derive the dimension formula, dimension for the physical parameters. One by using formula, the other one by using the SI unit. Here I list out the various physical parameters and its dimension. Here comes the velocity. Already we discussed about the velocity and also the mass, the volume and the area. Area and volume is very simple. By the formula itself, discuss about the square meter or the cubical value of the dimension, so L square and L cube. Whereas density, the formula is mass by volume. Thus comes the value nothing but what? ML minus 3. Here, similarly, the velocity also, the rate of change of displacement, because L divided by T. And then acceleration also, often we repeated the thing. So, that is similarly force and then energy, power, frequency. Frequency we know very well about that. Respect to the time, respect to the time seconds, the frequency is determinated. So, 1 by T is the unit for the frequency. So, dimension is T minus 1. This is very simple enough. And similarly, the torque and the moment of inertia. Moment of inertia comes I equivalent to MR square. Nothing but what? M, the dimension is M. And R square talks only about the dimension value of any length. So, M into L square. Here, capacitance, resistance is very, very important. And you people have studied about the LCR series as well as in parallel. So, capacitance, resistance and the inductance. So, all the three parameters are very important. Here comes the electric current. That is, a current comes into the play. Here comes the resistance. The resistance, here the dimensions I have written in the both the way. One by using the Q, the other one by using the I. Whereas Q represents the charge of the particle, whereas I represents the flow of the current. Both can be linked. Here, ML square T minus 3, I power minus 2. If not, ML square T power minus 1, Q power minus 2. How to relate these two equations? So, the thing is, the flow of current, nothing but, that is the current equal rate of change of the flow of charges. I equivalent to Q divided by T. Whereas the Q is small letter Q as well as capital letter Q. So, Q represents only the charge of the particle. The flow of nothing but rate of change of the flow of the particle. So, according to this equation, if I write this, I am going to rewrite this equation in terms of Q. So, now the dimension is ML square T minus 3. Whereas I power minus 2 can be written as Q divided by T. So, Q as such is the charge particle. They have no dimensional unit. Q can be represented as Q. Whereas time is the form of a capital T. Both comes under minus 2. I power minus 2 means both comes under minus 2. So, now I am extending this equation ML square T power minus 3 Q power minus 2 divided by T minus 2. When I rewrite this equation, minus 2 goes up becomes T plus 2. T plus 2 or minus 3 becomes M power 1 L square T minus 1 Q power minus 2. So, this is the dimension value which I am expressing in the form of a charge particle. So, the same way capacitance also can be written as in the form of a current or in the form of a charge particles. Whatever may be the convenient, you can come across in both the things. This is the importance of the link between the current and the charge. And similarly, viscosity nothing but ML minus 1 T power minus 1. So, viscosity nothing but the resistance of flow of the liquid. So, that can be expressed only by the unit Newton second per meter square. So, later on, the viscosity formula is nothing but Newton second per meter square. This is the unit for the viscosity. From this, we are going to calculate the dimension for this. Already we come across what is the formula for the Newton. Newton unit is kilogram meter per second square into second per meter square. So, your kilogram means mass and meter means length, second means time square. Here is also second time, meter square means L square. So this is the unit for this. When I rearrange this equation, m takes a value of 1, if L 2 goes up means minus 2, already 1 is there. So L takes a value of minus 1, 2 is there, again goes numerator minus 2, t becomes minus 1. So this is the dimensional formula for the viscosity. This derived this viscosity dimensional formula only from the SI units. So in this way you have to rearrange, you have to check, you have to correct the dimension for all the remaining physical parameters only by this way. Here comes the sums based only on the dimension and the SI units. Here, to see the question, you should not be frightened about the question, because there is nothing to understand the meaning of the sum. Nothing to understand the meaning of the sum. Rather, you should find out what are the parameters given in the problem and what is asked to be evaluated. That is enough. First thing is, if dimension of critical velocity Vc, the notation for the velocity is given as Vc. If dimension of critical velocity Vc of a liquid flowing through a tube expressed as, the notation is eta, rho and r. The suffix is x, y and z, where eta, rho and r are the coefficient of viscosity of liquid. Here the zeta is called as the coefficient of viscosity of the liquid, rho is called as the density of the liquid and r is called as the radius of the tube respectively. They asked to evaluate what is the value for x, y and z. So no need to understand the meaning of whether the liquid is flowing through a tube or a pipe or whatever the material. That is not an important parameter or important consequences over here. Here, what is given, what is asked? The given parameter are viscosity and the density and the radius. They asked to evaluate the x, y, z and they are equating this with respect to the velocity. So, dimension of critical velocity of a tube only is expressed in the form of this notation. So, the critical velocity as such Vc only is expressed in the form of eta x, rho y and r z. They asked to evaluate only the x, y and z. In the previous session, we discussed something about the how to evaluate the dimension for the particular physical variable by using SI unit or by using the formula. Here, the coefficient of viscosity, viscosity holds a particular SI unit, viscosity holds a particular formula. You people should be very clear enough in the dimension of the viscosity by using SI unit or by using the formula. Both plays an important role. The both values, it seems to be the correct. Because the last session we discussed something about the evaluation of the dimension by using formula and also by SI unit. Both comes the same value. So any one of the method, just follow it to evaluate the dimension for the viscosity. And next comes the dimension of the density. Density nothing but what? Mass by volume. Already we discussed about that. I show the how to derive the density by using formula as well as also by using SI unit. Next comes the simple parameter radius. Radius talks about the length only, the only dimension of a length, not anything else. The standard thing. So all these three is equating to the dimension of a velocity. This is velocity. Velocity is only equated to the this new parameter and they asked to evaluate what is the value for x, y, z. Here the velocity dimension is mt minus 1. Here the velocity dimension is lt minus 1. M is not there for the velocity. So m takes the value of 0. I told you the dimension should be enclosed in the square bracket. M lt should be enclosed there and the numerical value of a m lt should be written over there. In the superfix, one is velocity notation is lt minus 1, here m is 0, l is 1, t is minus 1. Here comes viscosity dimension is m l minus 1 t minus 1. M takes a value of 1, l is minus 1, t is minus 1. Here density, people are very familiar with that. Mass by volume, m takes a value 1, l is minus 3 and t is not there, but still you have to put what? T is nothing but equal to 0. Here the radius. Radius, I told you, is talks only about the length, dimension of the length. Only comes l only will be there. But still, m is 0, l is takes a value 1, t is 0. So, rho, that is the viscosity is under x, the density is also under y and the r is under z. So, the rotation x, y, z. Now, equating the left hand side as well as the right hand side, just frame the equation, arithmetic equation. This is nothing but is called as principle of homogeneity. According to the principle of homogeneity, I have to equate both the left hand side is equal to right hand side. By equating LHS and right hand side, LHS equivalent to RHS, I am going to calculate what is the x, y and z value. Principle of homogeneity. By the principle of homogeneity, I am going to calculate the what is the value for x, y and z. Here comes x. Only considering about m. Only considering about what? M alone in the first cases. M takes the value what? X. Because only 1 is there. So, x takes a value of what? Y. Only x. Here, m is also only 1 under y. So, y takes a value for only 1. Y into m nothing but what? Only 1 into y nothing but y. Here, z takes a value. Considering only m alone, z is 0. There is no z value in the particular case. So, x and y. Coming to the left hand side, here also the dimension for velocity is lt minus 1. So, m is 0. So, I can say x plus y is equal to 0. This is our first equation. Next, considering a l, I have to frame three such equations by using the above dimension. So, next comes a l. L plays a role about what? Minus 1 over here. Just multiply x into minus 1, I think but minus x. Next equation is L takes a value minus 3. So multiply y into minus 3 is getting what? Minus 3y. Here L is nothing but only 1. So 1 is nothing but plus z. That is z is equal to here comes 1. L takes a value 1. This is our equation number 2. The third equation considering about t. So, t means x takes a value minus 1. So, minus x is there for the t and y is not at all over there. So, y is 0. Z is also 0. So, minus x alone is in the equation. So, minus x is equivalent to here is also minus 1. So, minus 1. So, x, this is our equation number 3. Equation 3 is very simple to sort out. Minus x is equivalent to minus 1. So, according to the equation, x is equal to 1. So, I just find out the value for x. X takes a value 1. So, this is equation number 4. I got the value for x equal to 1. Just substitute the value of x equal to 1 in equation 1. So, now substituting x equal to 1 in equation 1. So, x plus y equal to 0. So, x takes a value 1 plus y equal to 0. So, y takes a value of minus 1. So, I got the value for y is equal to minus 1. Next, my aim is to calculate what is the value for z. Ultimately, I have to go for the equation number 2. So, substituting the value of x and y in equation number 2. So, x takes a value 1. Already, minus is there, so minus 1 will be there. The equation is minus x minus 3y plus z equal to 1. Here, the x value is 1, so minus 1. Here, y is minus 1. So, in minus into minus becomes plus 3 into 1 plus z is equal to 1. So, minus 1 plus 3 plus z equal to 1. So, minus 1 plus is nothing but what? 2. 2 plus z equal to 1. Z equal to 1 minus 2. So, z value is minus 1. So, I got the value for x, y and z as 1 minus 1 minus 1. So, this is the value for x, y and z. If energy E, velocity V and time T are chosen as fundamental quantities, the dimensional formula of the surface tension will be, question mark, the surface tension to be calculated, the surface tension to be find it out. Here comes the given only thing is energy, velocity and time only is given us. So from the above question, what I am conclude is surface tension is directly proportional to energy, velocity and the time. So the surface tension is directly proportional to e power a, b power b and t power c. My ultimate aim is to calculate what is the value for a, b and c, and then I go to conclude over here. Now next question is, I should know the formula or the SI unit for the surface tension to find out the dimension first. The formula for the surface tension, the formula for the surface tension is force by length. The formula for surface tension is force by length. Here force means, you know very well, M into A. Length is nothing but what? L. So again I have to come for the formula is force is mass into acceleration divided by length. Acceleration again is nothing but simplified into what? Mass into velocity per time into the length. Velocity again is simplified as displacement by the time. Displacement nothing but what? L divided by time into, already time is there and L is also there. So my dimension is capital M. Here LL get cancelled. T divided by T square. Nothing but MT minus 2. So MT minus 2 is the surface tension, dimension for surface tension for the length. So surface tension dimensional formula is M1T minus 2 and ultimately L is nothing but what? 0. I have to express everything in the form of MLT. In other case I can write M is nothing but 1, L is 0, T is minus 2 in the order. This is the dimension for the surface tension. So the surface tension, the dimension formula is this evaluator. And next comes the energy. So the formula for the energy, the formula for the energy is nothing but power into the time. So now time is the SI units, no need to worry about that. Power is nothing but work done. But the ratio of the work done with respect to the time is the power. So work done by time is the power into the time. Here time get cancelled one another. I left out only with the unit namely called as work done. Again the work done can be, again the formula for the work done is force into the distance. So force into the distance. So force comes mass into acceleration into the distance. So acceleration nothing but rate of change of velocity. So again M into velocity by the time into the distance. Next the velocity. Next comes the velocity. The formula for the velocity is M into displacement. Displacement respect to the time. Again time is there into time. Here is also distance is there. So displacement and the distance both are same, so no need to worry about that. So E equivalent to M into distance as well as distance is also capital L, displacement is also capital L. Here time, T into T nothing but what? T square. So E equivalent to M into L square, that T goes numerator, T minus 2. So this is the dimensional formula for the energy. M L square T minus 2. Next come the velocity. Velocity is nothing but rate of change of displacement. So ultimately the formula for this is L T minus 1. So rate of change of displacement means from here itself. So displacement by time. So displacement by time is nothing but, so L divided by T. It goes numerator, Lt minus 1. This is the dimension formula for the velocity. And next comes the time. Time is simply t. So, I just evaluate the dimensional formula for all the physical parameter, namely surface tension, energy and the velocity and the time. Just substitute the all the parameters, substituting all the dimensional value of the parameters in the Roman letter 1, the equation, the Roman letter 1. So, m1 l0 t minus 2, that is proportional to E. E is nothing but ml square m1 l square t minus 2. The exponential is A. Velocity is nothing but lt. So, m takes a value 0, l is 1, t is minus 1. Roman letter is B. And next comes about t. T is only this. So, t. T power So now I am rewriting this equation again, t minus 2, that is equivalent to exponential. To remove the exponential term, I have to include some constant. The constant is immaterial, can be neglected. The constant may be a numerical value, it need not to be a physical parameter, because physical parameter is already enclosed in the equation. The constant, it terms to be only a numerical value. The numerical value can be neglected over here by the principle of homogeneity. So, according to this, I can remove the exponential term. I can put as what? Equivalent sign. So, m1 l square t minus 2 power a. Here, m0 l1 t minus 1 to power 0. Here, m is 0, l is also 0, t is 1. The exponential term is 0. My aim is to calculate what is the value for a, b, c and then substitute in the equation, namely called as Roman letter 1. Now, according to this equation, I have to, by the principle of homogeneity, I have to say that LHS is equivalent to RHS. If it is not possible, I am not able to evaluate the value ABC. So, in all the cases, I am going for the equation principle of homogeneity method. So, according to this equation only, I am going to evaluate the new exponential value, namely called as A, B and C. Here, now consider the m in all the equations. So, m takes a value 1. So, multiply with respect to A. So, A. 1 into A, A. Here, m is 0. Here is also m is 0. Here comes, m takes a value 1. So, my equation is, from equation 1, I can able to assign the value for A is equivalent to 1. Next, consider the L. L as what? 2A. So, 2A, here L takes a value is 1, here L is 0, so 2A plus B, here is also L is 0. So, my equation number 2. So, 2A plus B equivalent to 0. Next, third equation, considering T alone. So, T is 2A. 2A, here is minus B. Here is plus C, here is minus 2. This is equation number 3. So, from considering the equation 1, I got the value A equivalent to 1. So, I am just going to substitute the value of B in the equation. Equation number 2. So, substituting the value of A in equation 2. Now, 2 into 1 plus B equivalent to 0. So, B, 2 plus B equivalent to 0, B takes a value of minus 2. So, I got the value of B as what? Minus 2. Next, I have to evaluate what is the value for C. So, next I have to calculate what is the value for C. So, substituting the value of A and B in equation 3. So, equation 3 is minus 2a minus b plus c equivalent to minus 2. Here, minus 2 into a takes a value of 1 minus b's value is minus 2 plus c, that is equivalent to minus 2. Here, minus 2 minus minus plus 2 plus c equivalent to minus 2. So, minus 2 plus 2 becomes 0 plus c equivalent to minus 2, c value is minus 2. So I got the value for C is also to be as what? Minus 2. Now substitute the value of A, B, C in the equation Roman letter 1. So S is equal to, or S is proportional to, E power of 1 and then V power of minus 2 and T power of minus 2. So this is the final answer end up with. So the value for A, B, C is found to be as what? 1, minus 2 and minus 2. Now substituting this in the above equation, the surface tension is equivalent to or proportional to E power 1, B power minus 2 and T power minus 2. So this is the conclusion I get up with.